Jesus said the seed would sprout and grow. He knew not how. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It can be very tempting to believe that we ourselves are the thing that gets us through, that we are the solution to our own problems, that we are the cure for our own maladies. It's very tempting. It's part of the human condition that we all share to see ourselves as either saving ourselves or sinking alone. It's very easy sometimes for us to forget God's role as our source, as our destination, and as our companion along the way. It can be easy to forget the love of God in the hearts of those people around us. I believe God is at work in our lives, like the seed that grows we know not how, as the scripture said. I'll tell you a story that helped me see that in my life. 2 years ago this month, I was in the Holy Land. We were in Jerusalem, and after 2 weeks pilgrimage, I was getting ready to leave Israel and Palestine. I was a part of a group of 30 pilgrims in Jerusalem, and the group included my own parishioners, our bishop, and other people from the Diocese of New York and other places. One parishioner and I planned a 3-day layover in Istanbul on the way home. Of the 30 of us, only the two of us were planning to stay for a few days in Istanbul. She had always wanted to see Istanbul, and I had been there and was very happy to show her around the city a little bit and see it again myself. The other 20 people in our group were switching planes in Istanbul, but going back straight to New York. When we got on the flight out of Tel Aviv to Istanbul, I got suddenly and violently sick. Group members, parishioners, our bishop, I was in a different diocese, our bishop Andy and his wife Margaret, the flight crew, the airport grounds crew, the airline customer service staff, got me on my wobbly legs, off the plane, through the airport, helped me switch my ticket, cancel my reservations in Istanbul, and got me on to the flight back to New York with the rest of the group. A few days after I would have been in Istanbul, in the neighborhood where I would have been staying, a car bomb blew up a bus full of policemen and passers by on the sidewalk. I cannot say God spared me, although it's tempting when I'm tempted to think my sudden illness was some sort of divine intervention. I pause and I remember that the bus full of policemen died. I have no reason to believe that God loves the policeman less than he loves me. I have no reason to believe that their wives, children, and parents miss them more than mine would miss me. That is not the lesson I learned. Tempting though it is to think about it that way sometimes. It's not the lesson I learned. The lesson I learned is that I was invited to live in the kingdom of the seed that sprouts I know not how. Right here on earth, in Istanbul Airport. I was invited into the kingdom of the seed sprouts I know not how by the love of God in the hearts of my fellow pilgrims, my parishioners, including the parishioner who gave up her stay in Istanbul to help me, my bishop and his wife, the flight crew who never met me, the ground crew who helped me get me from the plane to the terminal, and the customer service staff who changed my ticket so that I could go home. God was at work in the people around me, present in those who cared for me when I was sick. Sick, dizzy, wobbly-legged, with a shocking combination of bodily fluids coming out of me, half a world from home. What seeds had I planted? I thought I had planted seeds for a 3-day stay in Istanbul. What I got was an entry, unplanned, into the kingdom of heaven, right here on earth. These people are sprouting the seed I know not how. Now, this is a dramatic story with a brightly drawn set of good people doing clearly visible good things, and they are very good people, and particularly to me, these were very good things, make no mistake about it. But how many times a day do you suppose the love of God is at work about us, present in the hearts of those around us in ways that we can and cannot see? The invitation of the good news of Jesus Christ is to pause, to recall the seed that sprouts and grows, we know not how. God created the seed. God sprouts the seed. I hope we remain open to the hand of God at work in our lives, in ways small and big. On that plane and in that airport, I felt terrible sick. I felt challenged by last-minute travel complications in a foreign land. But what I felt most of all, oddly enough, was a sense of peace. The peace of knowing I was not alone. The peace of the kingdom leaves less room for fear. This is our God. This is our life in God. Can I get an amen?